Hello everyone, welcome to Luqman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 20th June 2020. Fine, so let us straight away start with which are the important articles that have appeared in today's The Hindu newspaper. You can see that for prelims examination and for mains examination we have segregated them. So these are the topics here, names of the topics and the page number. So one by one we will first see which are the important topics for mains examination, then we will see which are the topics for prelims examination. Okay, so first topic is your editorial, page number 6, revolving door. This article is important for your mains examination as well as prelims examination from let's say polity section. Okay, so for mains examination GS2 part and for prelims examination polity part. Fine, so the article is basically talking about anti-defection law. The article is talking about anti-defection law. So which are the keywords that we should look into is anti-defection law, role of speaker and recent examples of these political defections. So first of all, I will give you the background of the article. In first part, it is explaining in the state assembly of Manipur recently there were several political defections, and because of that there is political instability in the state, we can say that in Manipur. And the first half of the article is talking about or explaining whatever the defections it is having, the number of defection and all these things, political parties. That is not important for our examination, but what is important for our examination is you can see in this part the examples of recent political defection. See here, Karnataka state, Madhya Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. So one by one here you can see that MP in Madhya Pradesh, the political defections and change of ruling party or the government, we can say that because of those defections in 2020, we can remember in recent past. Like the Karnataka political crisis, the same thing happened in 2019, and the let's say in 2016, two states like Arunachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand let's say experienced the same phenomenon. So here it is talking about role of speaker, who has the authority to decide upon the defections. We will see that what is anti-defection law, who has the authority and all these things. So here it is talking about the biased role played by speaker, because speaker generally belongs to, mostly belongs to the government or the ruling party, right? So it is said that it plays biased role in deciding the defections or political defections. At the same time, if we have look at this statement which can be directly written in your answer in the examination, in the absence of any amendment to the law suitably, the only incentives for defectors is no possibility that voters might punish them in by-elections. However, the article is also saying that this is very less possibility, because we have seen that in Karnataka, who were those MLAs who were defected got re-elected. Okay, so we can say that even the voters are not going beyond the identity politics like this one, or it is emboldening parties to remain or seize the power through immoral mechanizations. Fine. So this is what the essence of topic for mains examination. What kind of questions we can expect is that with reference to recent political defections in some states, you can give these examples including the recent one, Manipur. Discuss the need of amendment to the anti-defection law. Fine. So basically the biased role of speaker, and we can use this word. This word is very unique here, shenanigans. Now this shenanigans means those who cause mischief, or let's say for selfish purpose they do such kind of let's say deceit in the political arena. We can use this word as shenanigans. Okay, so need of amendment to anti-defection law, you can go on discussing this part with the help of these examples here. Enlist the grounds for political defections under 10th schedule of Indian Constitution, and do you think they are sufficient to prevent political defection? So such kind of question can be expected in your examination. The grounds for political defections, let us see that. Now this part is important for your prelims as well as mains examination, the basics about anti-defection law. So if we take the brief background, in NCRT itself we have seen the phenomenon called as Ayaram Gayaram. Now MLA Gaya Lal from Haryana, basically he changed his party thrice within one night in 1967, and therefore the anti-defection law sought to prevent such kind of political defections. Now this law, which was included in 1985 through 52nd Constitutional Amendment Act, and the 10th schedule was added to our Indian Constitution. This is basic information which is also given in NCRT, 11th standard NCRT Constitution at Work, as well as M. Lakshmikant. Okay. At the same time, it lays down the process through which the legislator are disqualified on the grounds of defection by presiding officers of legislature. So presiding officers, if it is assembly, then we can say that it is the speaker, or if it is the Lok Sabha, then we can say that it is the speaker, or if it is the legislative council or Rajya Sabha, then we can say that it is the chairman. Okay, so basically the presiding officer decides on these defections. You can see here speaker or the chairman of the house. The decision of disqualification is final. Whatever the speaker or the chairman, that is presiding officer, decides on that issue is final. However, in Kihito Holohan case 1992, the Supreme Court here, had said that basically the presiding officer in these cases acts as a tribunal, and therefore his or her decision is subject to judicial review. So we can say that not the ultimate decision taken by the presiding officer, it is under judicial review. Okay, now what are the grounds for disqualification and which are the exception? This is basic information that you should know. And the grounds for disqualification, like voluntarily giving up the membership of political party, if he votes or abstains in the house contrary to the any direction given by political party, we need to know that political party issues whips regarding the voting legislative house. So any member who is independently elected joins any party, again he is supposed to be defected. If any nominated member joins any political party after end of 6 months, then it is political defection. Which are the exceptions here? Exception is that where 2/3 of legislature of political party decides to merge with another political party, then they are not called as defections. Okay. At the same time, if any person is elected as chairman or speaker, he can resign from his party and rejoin the party after demitting from that post. So that will not be called as defection under anti-defection law or the 10th schedule of Indian Constitution. So these are exceptions. Now this was the 52nd Amendment Act, and now the next amendment to this 10th schedule was related to was through 91st Amendment Act in 2003. There were two important aspects to this amendment. Is that earlier there was the provision for 1/3 of the elected members of political party considered as merger. However, this changed because of this 91st Amendment Act. Now it has become at least 2/3 of the members. Okay, this is one position. And at the same time, this Amendment Act made it mandatory for all those switching political sides to resign their legislative membership. That means they have to re-elect for that position again after deciding for, let's say, giving up the earlier membership of a political party through which it has elected to that position. Fine. So this was the basic information which can be helpful for your prelims examination also on this topic. Now the next article that had appeared in the foreign page, now the China embraces the Bangladesh in trade. Now this is important for, let's say, geopolitics of South Asia. This is important for your mains examination GS2 IR. Fine. So what are the important words, keywords here? You can see that Bangladesh is among the least developed countries, LDC. This is given here in this article. At the same time, it is talking about APTA, APTA, Asia Pacific Trade Agreement. We will see the let's say brief information on that. So basically, Bangladesh, China, as well as India is the part of this agreement. It is talking about this agreement wherein the Bangladesh receives the preferential treatment by other countries being the LDC, okay, least developed countries. At the same time, the unique word here, economic diplomacy, or whatever the trade, bilateral trade or regional trade, the policies we have between or among the countries, it is called as economic diplomacy. At the same time, the geopolitics of South Asia. So such kind of words, whenever appear in your articles, they are important for your mains examination. Fine. So what kind of question that we can say that? Basically, the article is talking about that the China is, let's say, giving tariff exemption to 97% of exports from Bangladesh, and the types of products here, fisheries and leather sector or leather products, it is talking about, and this is going to benefit Bangladesh in terms of tariff benefits, tariff exemptions. Like India and China relations or bilateral trade, it is skewed towards China, and therefore Bangladesh is going to benefit from that. In terms of, let's say, the recent COVID pandemic hardships that the country is facing. Fine. So the question can be framed like, mention the recent developments which suggest that China has made inroads into South Asia. Discuss its implications on India's interest in South Asian region. Now such kind of question can be let's say asked in your GS2 paper in mains examination. So the developments, one of the developments you should mention this one, okay. There can be another developments like in Sri Lanka, the China is providing soft loans for the development of infrastructure projects like Hambantota port is being developed. Or you can give the example of Bangladesh. At the same time, you can give the example of Pakistan, Gwadar port, it is developing. So such kind of inroads, we can say that even with Nepal, relations of China have been improving, and it is providing infrastructure development in Nepal also. Such kind of development should be mentioned in the answer. Okay. For prelims purpose, what is this APTA here? Asia Pacific Trade Agreement. Okay, earlier it was called as Bangkok Agreement, and it is intra-regional, Asia region and Pacific region. So it is intra-regional trade agreement that was signed among 6 countries in 1975. Which are these 6 countries? Bangladesh, China, India, Republic of Korea, Laos, PDR and Sri Lanka. So some countries from Asia region, some countries from, let's say, Pacific Ocean region, and therefore even the Mongolia is in process to become the 7th member of this agreement. What is the speciality of this agreement? Basically, this agreement recognizes the least developed countries, and the preferential treatment is to be given to these least developed countries in terms of tariff barriers. Fine. So this was for your prelims examination. The next article for prelims examination, this is for mains examination in terms of GS3 environment section, environment and ecology section for mains examination. So here it is talking about the coal auctions that were undertaken by the government of India, and the article is talking about the its impact on environment. Okay, so concerns related to environment. So these three points that were raised by the earlier, or let's say previous environment minister Jairam Ramesh, and he is talking about the environmental cost of mining and transportation coal, loss of valuable forest cover, as well as the public health concerns due to the pollution. The coal that is largely used for thermal power production, and from that many pollutants are emitted from those thermal power plants, and they are let's say cause of concern for public health. So these three points should be mentioned in the answer whenever the question is talking about coal being the let's say the impact of coal on various aspects of life, or we can mention these. First of all, environmental cost, forest cover or deforestation, at the same time public health concern. Fine. So the article mentions in the conclusion or last part here that India has committed to ensuring that fossil fuels contribute to no more than 60% of its energy production by 2020 in Paris Agreement. Now, what is Paris Agreement in 2015? We'll go into details after let's say in coming lectures whenever the article or the word come across, but here we will provide that there were INDCs, intended nationally determined contributions by various countries to this Paris Agreement in 2015, and India provided these three contributions, nationally determined contributions, and one of them was to increase the share of non-fossil fuels based electricity to 40% by 2030. So this point is basically talking about this part. The other two INDCs are improving India's emission intensity of its GDP by 33 to 35% by 2030 below the 2005 levels. Fine. And third one is increasing its forest cover that will absorb 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide by 2030. So this can be asked in your prelims examination, INDCs in Paris Agreement. Fine. So for mains purpose, impact of coal, such kind of question can be asked in examination. Discuss the environmental implications of coal mining in India. Fine, simple question for 10 marks, we can expect such question. Mention these three aspects as well as India's commitment to Paris Agreement. Next article, one small let's say article that was in news or today's newspaper, let me tell you, this appeared in this feature page or showcase in page number 12. Generally, yes, we have also advised that these two showcase pages to be, let's say, skipped while reading the Hindu newspaper. However, it will be beneficial if you scan them quickly. Okay, so look at this news here. एन्युलर सोलर इक्लिप्स, इतनी छोटी सी न्यूज़ है सिर्फ, बट हम बोल सकते कि हमारे एग्जाम के लिए इम्पॉर्टेंट है. बेसिक्स हमें पता होने चाहिए. व्हाट इज़ एन्युलर सोलर इक्लिप्स? इट इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट इन दिस वीकेंड वी कैन एक्सपीरियंस द एन्युलर सोलर इक्लिप्स ऑन द अर्थ, फ्रॉम द अर्थ, फ्रॉम वेरियस कंट्रीज इंक्लूडिंग इंडिया. हियर यू कैन सी दैट पार्ट्स ऑफ अफ्रीका, पाकिस्तान, इंडिया एंड चाइना. It will be visible. Now, what are the let's say what is solar eclipse and what are the different types of solar eclipse, like total solar eclipse, annual solar eclipse and partial solar eclipse? So let us see what is solar eclipse. Basically, solar eclipse is let me give you the position here. Suppose this is Sun and this is Earth and this is to be Moon, and this should be in line, all three bodies should be in line, so or in one line or in one plane we can say. And whenever the Moon is between the Sun and the Earth, then only we have the solar eclipse, because we can say that the Moon obstructs the Sun and that shadow is felt on the Earth, and that is nothing but what you can say, solar eclipse. Now this position is observed on which day, full moon day or new moon day? It's on new moon day. Okay, this position is observed on new moon day. Okay, so whenever there is a new moon day, we can say that the moon is generally between sun and located between sun and earth. And whenever there is let's say lunar eclipse, whenever there is lunar eclipse, at that time this is the sun and this is the earth and the moon is located here. So the shadow of earth we can see on the moon. Okay, shadow of earth is on the moon. So in both cases three bodies, celestial bodies, are in line with each other or in one plane. However, the location of moon changes in both cases. Here we see that lunar eclipse is observed on full moon day, on full moon day. So this is the basic concept. And let us see what are the three different types of solar eclipse here. So here first is total solar eclipse, and whenever we see that the moon completely blocks the solar disk, that becomes the total. You can see here the first diagram, completely blocking, the moon is completely blocking the sun. And the longest total solar eclipse that can last is 7.5 minutes. Basically not more than 8 minutes any solar eclipse is observed. Annular solar eclipse, we can say that annular here, see this diagram, and it is explained here in annular, so as annular solar eclipse here. Basically what happens is the full shadow of moon, that is called as penumbra. Okay, so the full, sorry, not penumbra, umbra, full shadow is not falling on the earth surface. While it is falling let's say before earth somewhere here, okay, and the partial shadow is there at some places. You can see these places here, this place and this place. This is the partial shadow observed here, that is called as penumbra region. Okay, so if we are located here on this earth surface here, from this position there will be partial solar eclipse. From this position it is partial solar eclipse. If we are here, then there will be total solar eclipse. If we are here, there will be total solar eclipse. However, you can see that we are here now in this position. And whenever we are in this position, we will have annular solar eclipse. We will have annular solar eclipse. Why this is happening? Because we are in the lighter shadow called as antumbra at that position. Okay. So when the moon is farther away in its orbit than usual, it appears too small to completely cover sun's disk. सो जैसे वो एक रिंग ऑफ फायर की तरह दिखता है, जैसे यहाँ पे देखो एनुलर सोलर इक्लिप्स एक रिंग ऑफ फायर, ठीक है, तो उसकी तरह दिखता है. एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन से दैट इट इज एनुलर. एंड व्हाट इज पार्शियल सोलर इक्लिप्स, वी कैन से दैट वेन एवर द अर्थ मूव्स थ्रू द लूनर पेनुम्ब्रा, सी हियर दिस इज पेनुम्ब्रा, एंड द पार्शियल सोलर इक्लिप्स कैन बी ऑब्जर्व फ्रॉम दैट पोजिशन ऑन द अर्थ. फाइन, सो दिस इज वेरी बेसिक्स of solar and new and lunar eclipse. And this is covered in NCERT. Most of you have understood, may have understood this concept. But yes, the annular, as we are going to observe annular solar eclipse this year, you can expect such kind of question, because this event is a rare event. This is observed, let's say, once in two or 3 years. Fine, so that's why it becomes important for your examination. So in prelims examination, such kind of MCQs we can expect like solar eclipse, when we observe solar eclipse, when we observe lunar eclipse, what is the condition here. So you can solve that question. Basic question can be expected from this aspect or from this topic in your prelims examination. Now this article, yes, we are going to have follow up on India China relations and whatever the skirmishes that happened along the line of actual control in Ladakh region. So we have seen about the Galwan Valley in the previous lecture, right? So basically the article is talking about the information on Galwan Valley and its, let's say, environment. Galwan Valley is arid inhospitable area. So we need to know that. At the same time, why it is considered important, we have said that this is geostrategic location. Why it is called as a geostrategic location? Because it leads to the Aksai Chin region, a disputed plateau claimed by India but controlled by China. Fine. So that is why it becomes important or geostrategically important. At the same time, the article is also mentioning about India's nature of boundary with China. Now, what is this nature of boundary here? In the western region, it is saying that it is, let us say, see here, 4056 kilometer border between India and China runs through glaciers and snow deserts and rivers in the western region and thickly forested mountains in the east, like in Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. In the east, it is thickly forested mountains, while in the what you can say west, it is talking about deserts or the snow deserts or the cold deserts like Ladakh region. Okay, so this is the basic information we should let's say take it as an input for your examination. Fine. So Galwan Valley and nature of India-China border in western and eastern sector. Next article, the individual contribution to NDRF gets green light from Finance Ministry. Now about NDRF and the PM Care, PM Cares and NDRF, SDRF, this has been covered in the earlier lectures on the, let's say, 18 June, the day before yesterday. And the article has mentioned, this particular article has mentioned about Prime Minister's National Relief Fund. Now this fund is also important for your prelims examination. Let us cover basic information about this one. PMNRF was established in 1948. Originally, it had the objective of, let us say, garnering the public contributions for assistance of partition refugees. The basic motive at that time was, let us say, helping those people who suffered the losses in partition, let us say India-Pakistan partition after independence. However, after that, that was, let us say, discontinued, and now the objective is to provide the immediate relief to families of those killed in natural calamities. At the same time, it is having, let us say, benefits for victims of major accidents and riots, as well as medical expenses of acid victim, attack victims. Okay. So, whenever you have, let us say, question related to your ethics also, and suppose there is any natural calamity, if the case study is talking about any riots or major accidents or expenses, acid attack victim, you should know that the funding can be done from this Prime Minister National Relief Fund. You should keep this in mind. Okay. At the same time, for prelims examination, this is important. Now, earlier this was managed by a committee which included Prime Minister and Deputy Prime Minister, Finance Minister, Congress President and representative of Tata Trustees and an industry representative. Now this was managed by a particular committee. However, this practice was discontinued from 1985, and now the Prime Minister is the sole responsible person for this, we can say that, National Relief Fund, and on his behalf a joint secretary in PMO administers this fund. Okay, so this basic information is important, and the PM CARES Fund and NDRF, which is statutory fund, NDRF under Disaster Management Act, that has been covered on the 18th June, the Hindu analysis. The prelims question we can expect like this on PMNRF. Okay, so you can solve this question after reading this article. Next is Khelo India Centers planned for 1000 districts. Now the Khelo India Centers, it is talking about planning to establish 1000 district level Khelo India centers. Now Khelo India program was launched 2 years back. You can have the basic information. 2017 mein wo launch kiya tha. And what is the objective here? To strengthen the entire sports ecosystem to promote twin objectives of mass participation and promotion of excellence in sports. So these are the twin objectives of the program, and this is very let's say being successful because the talented players are being identified and they are provided the monetary support. Here you can see that the annual financial assistance of 5 lakh per annum for 8 years. This information can be asked for in your prelims examination. Now the program has been divided into 12 verticals. Which are these 12 verticals? You can go through this 12 verticals, scan them. However, this let's say Khelo India centers are being you can see here utilization and creation of upgradation. Utilization and creation and upgradation of sports infrastructure. So basically it is creating the new sports infrastructure. At the same time, you can see here the centers would either be run by past champion on their own or co-op there as a coaches. Basically the motive here is for involving this, let's say, earlier champions in that particular fold. So it will provide them, let's say, livelihood, employment opportunities for those as coaches. So that is again very important aspect of this program. So IAEA passes critical resolution against Iran. The article is talking about that there is a resolution passed in IAEA, International Atomic Energy Authority. So this agency has passed this resolution on Iran to have access to two sites that Iran is blocking, or the let's say information or access to these sites. So what is IAEA? This is important for your prelims examination. So it is let's say International Center for Cooperation in Nuclear and Atomic Field, that was established in 1957. So it is United Nations agency. However, it is not specialized agency of United Nations. Try to understand that. You can be tricked in your examination. It is not specialized agency of United Nations. The main motive here is to promote the peaceful use of nuclear technology. Headquarter in Vienna. You should know the headquarter of these bodies. Members 171, and India is one of the founding member. It joined in 1957 itself. So such kind of question can appear in your prelims examination about IAEA, and you should be prepared about the basic information. Fine. Again, the culture part for your prelims examination, the same article. Yesterday we have seen that how the culture related article have been appearing at the last page of the Hindu here. Look at this article. So yesterday also we have seen one article related to culture part. Today also we have seen similar kind of article. Here it is talking about Kiladi excavation site in Tamil Nadu. Fine. So let us try to know about Kiladi. The similar kind of article appeared here in November 2, 2019 on same archaeological site, excavation site Kiladi. Let's say unearthing the Vaigai Valley civilization of Sangam era Tamil Nadu. So two times up till now in last 6 months we have this article related to Kiladi excavation site. So expect definitely this, the question in your prelims examination related to Vaigai Valley civilization or Kiladi excavation site. So let us know basics about it. What are the basics? It is an urban civilization existed in Tamil Nadu in Sangam era on the banks of Vaigai river. Now the important part is Sangam literature, Sangam era and Vaigai river, or the Vaigai civilization. Here we will see that the Tamil Sangam is an assembly of poets and its seat in Madurai between 4th century BC and 2nd century BC, एंड दीज वर्क्स आर कलेक्टिवली कॉल्ड एज संगम लिटरेचर. सो देर वेयर थ्री मीटिंग सच मीटिंग संगम एंड कलेक्टिवली द वर्क्स वेयर कॉल्ड एज संगम लिटरेचर. दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यूर एंशियंट हिस्ट्री पार्ट ऑल्सो एंड कल्चर पार्ट ऑल्सो. सो लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दिस सिविलाइजेशन हियर. द इम्पॉर्टेंट और द इंटरेस्टिंग फीचर ऑफ किलाड़ी एक्सकवेशन साइट इज दैट टिल नाउ वी हैवंट रिवील्ड एनी साइंस ऑफ रिलीजियस वर्शिप इन दैट साइट. सो वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट दैट अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट वॉट यू कैन से feature of the site is that they have learned the art of writing Tamil Brahmi script as early as 6th century BC during the early historic period. Now this is very unique and have some kind of similarities related to your Indus Valley civilization, because they had also their own script at that time, as well as it was the urban civilization, right? So either you can expect the question in prelims examination, or you can expect the question in your mains examination GS1 culture part. Like questions can be framed like discuss the similarities between Indus civilization and Vaigai civilization. Just such kind of question have not been asked till now, and you can expect such kind of question in next year. Fine. So it has similarities, like it is urban civilization, at the same time it has a script, people knew writing particular script, right? So urban planning here, you can see that. Okay, so such kind of let's say inputs can be taken from this article. These information is not written in this article. Okay, this article is only talking about some excavations or the skeletal remains of child were excavated from that particular site. However, we need to know the background of that particular site. Fine. So this information, similar kind of prelims question we can expect. SC refuses, or Supreme Court refuses, to stay work on Central Vista. Now it is talking about again the cultural or heritage part of let's say India. It is talking about the renovation project or the Central Vista redevelopment project that the government of India has announced in 2019 here. It also has the Parliament redevelopment project as a part of this Central Vista redevelopment project, and it is to be completed by August 2022. Okay, so this complete Central Vista was let's say developed by Lutens, or let's say as a he was the French architecture at that time, and he designed these structures at that time. So that's why it becomes important for your architecture or modern architecture. So there are three phases of architecture we see that in our history: ancient architecture, then we have medieval architecture like Mughal architecture is there, and then in modern architecture we have Gothic or Indo-Gothic type of architecture. So such kind of question can be expected in your mains examination also. So basic information related to this plan, yes, from time to time the articles will again reappear related to this. What are the basic concerns that this article is flagging here, the related to this redevelopment project, is that land use changes in the capital. Okay, so these are three concerns. First is land use change that is going to happen in that area. Also it is cultural heritage, history, and the symbol of vibrant democracy. So that's why we should not alter these structures. At the same time it is the very opaque and secret, the government is maintaining secrecy in development plan, and that is again one of the concern related to this Central Vista redevelopment project. Fine. So these inputs should be taken for your examination. So lastly, what are the important captions and quotations from today's articles? So first is from the editorial: in the absence of any amendments to anti-defection law, the only disincentives for defector is possibility that voters might punish them by by-elections. So it can be used in your answer. This is for your what you can say, the environmental and the environment part. What is that? Mining and transportation of cost coal would have heavy environmental cost, valuable forest cover, and the public health concern. So we have seen that in the, as a three aspects that we can raise whenever the question is talking about environmental impact of coal mining. At the same time, brief information on Paris Agreement and the central vista is the symbol of India's historic past, nationhood, and vibrant democracy. Or India-China relations and the border between India-China in the western parts, it is having deserts and rivers, cool desert. At the same time, in the eastern part, it is having the forested mountains. So such kind of inputs can be taken for your mains examination, including GS as well as SA. Whenever the question or essay is asked on the international relations or let's say environmental topic or geographical topic or political aspects, so you can use these inputs, captions and quotations for your writing essay also. Fine. So for further information related to the foundation batch as well as editorial discussions, which are which is the very important course for our current affairs part of your examination, especially mains examination, you can contact Lukman IAS. Thank you.